It is. Come on, yeah, I remember when they did the 72. It is not, what was 2015? You stuck in 72. Don't you know you better walk out of that chamber of hell and walk out of that jail and walk to your freedom? You holding up your blessing. Your blessing is right here. Somebody say, my blessing right here. You know it. That prophetic word came to pass in you that quick, brother. I saw you smiling, standing in front of that big truck. I said, look at my boy. I said, he sold a seed on Sunday and went to work on Monday and got some keys. Y'all better hear me today. Come on, give God praise. I said, now that's how it works. Am I right about it? He sold on Sunday and went to work. He was smiling too. Oh, Sean, he don't hold them up, boy. He let you know this is big baby, pound money. I said, wow. And I love that, how you put those little things on there. The family that prays together stays together. And that's so true. If you don't pray with your family, let's stop this foolishness. I'm talking to everybody under the sound of my voice. I hope I make you so mad that you go and just say, I'm so angry with that woman, I'm apologizing. Because I want God to be pleased with us. How many know you just took a step away of being a millionaire? Because the Jewish lineage, let me tell you something. No. The Jewish lineage right now, they have sown, and you sowed last week. That's why you got your miracle. This is the time that they sow. Am I right, Sherry? This is the time that they sow. And the heavens open and give them what they need. I said, but we've been traditionally bound for so many years, we never knew this. I mean, it was 50 days after Jesus was what? Crucified, am I right? Well, what do we celebrate after that? Say it, baby. Who said it? Well, thank you, sister. Let's get sister Hatcher right here. But the thing I'm trying to say to you is not until you get on one accord and one mind, something can happen. If you divide it, nothing's going to happen. But if you get on one mind and accord, you can move the heavens. That thing you've been asking God for years and for months is getting ready to shift for you today. As a matter of fact, this may sound crazy, but I'm glad it's not a lot of people here today. Honestly. You know that? Honestly, I'm glad it's not today. Because I feel free to tell you this. Whatever it is, and some of you got aunts with family members, you got aunties and uncles, daddies, cousins, you, I'm talking to you, friends, pick up that phone today, please. Do not let this day go without you saying something nice to someone. Because you got a big miracle coming your way. I'm talking about it's bigger than you think. You holding up what they want to release you. I see money being released like, oh my God, my God, my God. This is canceled right now. What's on that phone is cancer. Y'all hear what I said? I dare you to go to somebody and tell them you love them and you know you had it all against them. Honestly, watch and see. Tomorrow you're going to say, thank you, Jesus. I dare you to go to somebody right now. And I'm not trying to put you on blast. I'm just saying, do it and do it quick. Because the enemy is the one that got you with a haughty spirit. This is what the last days say. Men shall be lovers of themselves more than lovers of God. If you love yourself so much, you won't even hear God. You can't love yourself that much that you can't hear God. Now God is speaking to somebody right now. Is something in your life that you haven't confessed to that person or told them I'm sorry or said I know I was wrong. This is your time now. Because I couldn't get past what God was saying to me. Am I right about it? So it's time for the saints. Not talking about let's go win soul. You got to first win your soul. your soul is at stake. Y'all got what I'm saying? Yes. And because we don't need to put a big tent up and have a crusade. Because we will be under. Come on, somebody. Let's shout on that. And then today, my subject, I just want to give this to you. Where is the love? Turn and tell somebody, where is the love?
Where is the love?
And for a subtopic, do you really love God? I want Terry to read that same scripture out loud for me. 1 John, do that for me. That's not even on my lesson, but I want you to read that for me. The one I gave you in Sunday school. Read that out loud, because people need to hear God is love. And if the enemy got you twisted, and anybody partake with foolishness, you get a part of that curse. I'm not going to be a partaker of junk. I'm getting out of it. I see you in it, I'm running. Because you're not going to have me mixed up in that mess. Mm-hmm. Because if you keep your name clear, you'll be all right. Am I right? Okay, go ahead, brother. I gave you 4, I believe. Mm-hmm.
Love, let us love one another. Love is of God.
Yes.
Everyone that loves is born of God and knows God.
Who said that? Everyone loves what? Everyone that's born of God, do what? If you're born of God, then you can't hate anyone. If you say you know God, you really can't hate anyone. There's no way I can sit up here and know I despise you and preach a message. It may hurt. I don't care. You talk about me. It really doesn't matter to me. Call me what you want. You can call me anything you want. But I'm going to tell you this. This is God trying to free someone.
Amen.
If you want to be free, that goes down to you children. You better honor your fathers. But your days might be going. Please hear me good. And I know you're saying, why are you going down such an avenue? Because it is so. There is a spirit, and it's disrupting places. Not just here, not just with your job. It's in people's homes. And, you know, people rising up against each other. Mother-in-laws against sisters. Mother-in-laws against daughter-in-laws. Father-in-laws against father. The scriptures say that. But until we come to the unity and to the bond of peace, we're not going to see God. Come on, somebody. I know you say, well, if this is no set person, that's why I said I'm glad it's not full of days when we talk about, she was talking about so-and-so. I'm talking to you. Whoever you got along with, these that are here today, under the sound of my voice, write a note down. I have to forgive this person. And you know who that person is. Some people might have jabbed it out, but that's on them. It ain't on me no more for today. Because I'm free.
Amen.
I'm free. I'm free. The Bible says, whom the Son set free is free indeed.
Yes.
All right. One thing I won't stand before him and have to worry about is that I didn't give this word today. And I didn't understand why I had to do this, but I'm doing it. Amen? Because I'm ready for growth. I'm not ready for God to stifle me. You said any man love God will have the Spirit of God. What did you say?
For love is of God.
They know God. Amen? Amen. Now, I'm going to take my subject from 1 John. I believe I have 1 John 13. Yeah, 13. No, 1 John 4 and 20. Go there, dear. 1 John 4 and 20. Go back.
Amen. Say, I love God. His brother,
that's what I wanted. You heard that? If any man what?
Say he loves God and hates his
He's a liar. And God is love. How many know God is love? If you go back and you look at verse 7, like he said, beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. Speaking of not just filial love, but he's speaking of agape love. The love that is unconditional. God loves us with an unconditional love. A love that surpasses what I do for you, you do for me. If you don't, if you give me this, I give you that. Pardon each other. God will pass. He goes beyond your thoughts to see your needs.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody. How many know we need God to move? How many know we need a move of God? How many need a move of God for real? That's right. If you need a move of God, clap your hands and tell them something. And then verse 8 says, he who loves not knows. He said, not knows God, for God is love. And so if God is love, that's God's nature. If you're not loving people and you're doing the opposite, you're operating a nature that's not God. God's nature is love. God's nature is peace. You chasing after stuff that's pertaining to the world, like going to little activities, when you need to get your soul right with God.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Give God praise, everybody. Give God praise. Give God praise, yes. My God. Because one thing about it, if you have his nature, and I'm going to tell you this, if you have his nature, you can't even go to bed without that thing bothering you. If you have his nature. Did y'all hear what I said? And when you have his nature, it will wrestle you till you say, I got to get to that person. Am I right? Oh, come on, give God praise. Amen. Come on, I dare you to thank him. I dare you to glorify him. Because he alone is worth. Trying to get any glory out of this. I want God to get the glory. Honey, I don't benefit from you going back and telling your friend you was wrong. I don't benefit from that. God get the glory. Huh? Y'all can throw bricks. I don't know. Any telling that? But I'm telling you what God wants from you. You better make that thing right today. They get it right today. And sometimes when we think we're right and we're wrong, guess what? You just might have to oversight your inflated ego and put a pin in it and bush your big head and go back and say, I'm sorry. Come on, somebody. Am I right? Because a lot of times people, they feel like they so, you know, self-righteous that they're not, you know, wrong. But sometimes you can be wrong. And you be like, oh, I know I'm right.
I know I'm right.
You wrong as 12 best you. Go back and tell somebody, I'm sorry. I'm talking to somebody. You believe it or not, I'm talking to somebody. They trying to act like it ain't right. Honey, I know I'm in your pockets. So when we say we love God, we walk in what? Unity, man. Am I right? And then the Bible says in 9, and this was manifested the love of God toward us. He said, because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world. Listen to that. He sent his best into the world. Isn't that wonderful? That we might live through him. It's only through Christ and him being crucified that I can live and have a mindset of saying, I'm sorry. It's only through him, because I can't love you without God. I need God.